the year, let's go to the videotape. The best catch of July, robbing a player of a home run, Yvonne Calderon, White Sox. There he goes back, climbs the fence, and takes a home run away from Alan Trammell. Best catch by diving center fielder coming in. Lenny Dykstra of the Mets coming in, reaching in, and robbing Terry Francona of the Expos. The best tumbling catch of a sinking line drive by a left fielder, Bo Jackson of the Royals, taking a hit away from Cal Ripken Jr. The best recovery by an outfielder after falling down, again, Mr. Calderon of the White Sox. The best play by a shortstop for a forced play at second base, Ozzie Smith, who takes a hit away from Rafael Santana and flips to Tommy Herr. The best play by a pitcher, Bob Nepper of the Astros, who flips to Denny Walling, who throws to Glenn Davis for the out. The worst case of a left fielder losing the ball in the lights, Chris James of the Phillies. Where is it, Chris? The worst catch by a left fielder with no excuse, Kenny Landro of the Dodgers, who drops the ball. The worst catch by a third baseman of a routine foul pop-up, Rance Mullinix of the Toronto Blue Jays. The best wild pitch of July, Joe McGrain of the Cardinals. The best running block at home plate, Bo Jackson, getting ready for the football season. The best flying tackle by an outfielder after being thrown at, Willie Wilson of the Royals. The worst abuse taken out on a harmless tennis racket, Yvonne Lendl in the Wimbledon final. The best golf shot of July, Kenny Green, first round British Open, 58-yard chip shot, and the ball rolls in. The best original handshake by old-timers, Chichi Rodriguez and Gary Player in the senior U.S. Open. The punch of July, there it is, boom. Left hook by Mike McCallum, down goes Donald Curry. The best missed punch of July, Donnie Parker, swing and a miss. The worst butt of July, Juan Laporte and Lupe Suarez. Down goes Suarez. In August, the best catch by a right fielder, Tom Bernanski of the Minnesota Twins, coming over and makes the grab. Best catch by a diving center fielder, Kenny Williams of the Chicago White Sox. The best catch by a third baseman in foul territory, Kelly Gruber of the Toronto Blue Jays. Here he comes, and watch out, Kelly. Worst example of trying to throw away the evidence, Joe Niekro of the Twins, who throws away an Emery board. Hey, where did that come from? Niekro is suspended. Worst example of sportsmanship in soccer, Pan Am Games. The Mexican trainer comes off the bench and tackles Nelson Kirchner of Brazil. Worst example, hitting your opponent while he's down, Robert Hines, who illegally holds the rope and pounds away at Donald Bowen. The golf shot of August, Tom Kite, third round World Series of Golf, 16th hole, 180-yard shot, and the ball rolls in. The fastest human of the year, 25-year-old Ben Johnson of Canada in the red, 100-meter dash, a world record. There goes Johnson, 9.83. In September, the best catch by a left fielder, Chris James of the Phillies. Best teamwork on one play, Phillies. Shane Rawley, who flips to Mike Schmidt to Rick Shue for the out. Best combination on a pop-up, Tigers third base Tom Brookins to catcher Matt Noakes. The worst pickoff attempt of the year, Charlie Huff threw his leg, and the ball goes in the right field. Best left hook, John Meekins, boom, down goes Howard Stewart. And Michelle Marsh was at the game. Back with the fourth quarter in just a moment. Plays of the year, let's go to the videotape. In October, the two worst calls in the World Series, Game 7, Don Baylor called out at home by umpire Davey Phillips, and Tommy Herr called out at first by umpire Lee Wire. The friendliest strike replacement player, Kyle Mackey of Miami, who hugs the referee. The trickiest onside kick that doesn't work, Penn State against Syracuse. There it goes. The NBA fight of October, the Atlanta Hawks and the Indiana Pacers exhibition game. When it's all over, 21 players are fined a total of $16,000. The most irate hockey players, the New Jersey Devils, who try to climb the plexiglass in Pittsburgh. The cheap shot of the year, Flyers' Dave Brown, who high sticks Thomas Sandstrom. Brown is suspended 15 games. The best punch, Frank Tate. Watch the right hand, boom. Down goes Michael Olajide. In November, the longest shot, John Bagley of the Nets, 70-footer against Houston to end the first quarter, and it is a swish. The longest shot by little man, 5'3", Muggsy Bogues of the Bullets, 65-footer against Milwaukee, good. The best touchdown pass of November in the NBA, the Celtics, Larry Bird, on the fly to Connor Henry, who lays it in. The worst slash by a goalie, Flyers' Ron Hextall, who winds up and cuts down the Devils' Aaron Broughton. The best heavyweight hockey fight, 6'3", 215-pound Rob Probert of Detroit in the white, and 6'4", 210-pound Craig Cox of Vancouver in the dark. The best leap for a winning touchdown, running back Steve Sewell of the Broncos, who beats the Bears. The worst move by a defensive back after being beaten for a touchdown, the Vikings' Joey Browner, who picks up Mike Renfro and tries to drag him back over the goal line. The most determined player of the year, 250-pound William Wrighton of South Carolina State, trailing by 1 point last play of the game. Wrighton's kick is no good, but Grambling is called for roughing the kicker. The second time, Wrighton kicks again it's no good, but Grambling is offside. A third time, Wrighton kicks and misses, but again, Grambling is offside. So, for a fourth and final time, Wrighton kicks. The ball is in the air. It is good. And South Carolina State, on the fourth kick, beats Grambling 15-13. The longest golf shot, La Quinta, California, Lee Trevino's 17th hole, par 3, 167-yard shot, and it is a hole-in-one. The best bump and a cartwheel, 393-pound Bam Bam Bigelow, up and over. And Frank Field was at the game, trying to guess which way the cold front was coming. The plays of the year of 1987.